morning. Is this your wife in this ad?
Is she modeling lingerie and standing in front of the Tower of London?
Oh, yeah. I didn't notice the Tower of London. Hey, look, Carl, it's the Tower of London.
Your Majesty.
Give me that. It is so depressing that my friends have seen my wife in her underwear more recently than me.
See? That's why I would never marry an international supermodel. Who needs the grief?
I saw Shirley in her underwear when I got up this morning. She just got home from the night shift. She snuggled up next to me, put a little head on my shoulder just like an angel, and started snoring like a warthog. This working different shifts is gonna ruin my marriage.
Ruin mine.
Yeah, but you were the one working both shifts.
God, I was a workaholic.
Who gets the check?
They do.
Okay. Here you go, kid.
Okay, you can leech off us today, but tomorrow you're getting the tip.
Why does he always think that's funny? I have no idea.
We gotta go to school.
Let's go, monkey.
Look out, lady. Come on, huh?
Okay, Nick, we are way late. See you later, buddy.
Dad, you forgot something.
Oh, right.
No, you have to sign me in. If you don't sign me in, I'm not here.
I get it.
It's the drill day. You sign me in, and I go play. It's simple.
Oh, sure, for you. Your brain's still growing. Hey, Nick, sweatshirt.
It doesn't smell the way it does when Mom washes it.
Wash? Sarah, wait, where's my kiss?
I don't give kisses on Mondays. Sorry.
But you'll have to. It's the only way to escape the dreaded octopus queen! You see? Now I'm a happy octopus.
Okay, Daddy. Bye.
She's gonna be a real heartbreaker, isn't she?
Yeah, you know, it's funny. When I was single, I was an incredible hound. And now I have a beautiful daughter. Vengeance is mine, saith the Lord.
My stomach hurts.
Oh, your tummy hurts? Do what Daddy does. Belch.
Okay.
That's my girl.
Oh, my God, I can't believe we got him here so late.
Well, let's get out of here before she comes...
You can run, but you cannot hide.
Morning, Mrs. Newhouse. Morning.
Oh, is it still morning? Or maybe I shouldn't ask that of the Tardy boys.
It won't happen again, Mrs. Newhouse.
Never.
We promise.
Uh-oh. What's that I feel? Smoke?
Hi, Mrs. Newhouse. I'm Melinda Nichols. This is my son, Henry. I'm sorry, we had a little trouble finding the school. Here's your lunch. I didn't have time to make it, but there's a jar of peanut butter, a jar of jelly, and a sharp knife to cut your sandwich with. It was a joke.
Well, no one enjoys a good knife joke more than me. Hi there, Henry. How you doing? I'm Mrs. Newhouser. Now, why don't you go out and play with the lucky children whose mommies know what the clock is?
I don't know any of the other kids.
Henry, my son Nick's out there all alone. Dancing in that puddle. You want to go join him?
My dad said I have to keep clean today. We're going out to dinner with his new friend, Lisa.
Really? Go ahead and have fun. And tell Daddy Mommy said it's okay.
Divorced?
You got that, huh?
Yeah. I mean, I am too. It's really rough, isn't it?
Oh, boy, is it ever. It's all I can do just to hold it together.
Well, no pain, no gain. Why don't you come with me to the office? I will give you some forms you have to fill out.
Oh, geez, I'm running a little late. A client is meeting me at the courthouse and, like, now.
Then he will have to, like, wait.
Yikes.
Don't worry, the kids love her. She only scares the grown-ups.
She made me cry once.
I threw up after a parent-teacher conference. This is Bobby and Carl, and I'm Tom.
Tick-tock, tick-tock.
Okay, I'm going in. Nice to meet you, Tom.
Nice meeting you, too, Melinda. Whoa!
Nice meeting you, Melinda. Very smooth.
I wasn't trying to be smooth, but it came across that way?
Well, I found you vulnerable, yet strangely attractive.
my office.
Oh, but wait, I thought you were working out of your house.
I am. I programmed my computer to beat me so I wouldn't be late for work. I know. I'm my own boss now, but that's no reason to give myself special treatment.
Oh, yeah. You got this workaholic thing licked.
Daddy, can we have a play date after school?
Oh, sweetheart, I'm working today.
Yeah, me too. Oh, if only one of us had a home office so the dreams of these sweet children could be realized.
Okay, you can pick them up at 6.
Yay!
Love the soulful look.
It worked. Bye, Mr. Octopus.
See you later, Heartbreaker.
Don't worry, I forgot. I got something for you.
What's this?
It's an invitation to my birthday party on Saturday.
Oh, I'm invited to my own son's birthday party.
Yeah, you're the only one I asked who's not from class. Can you come?
Of course I can come.
Then just call Mom's number and RSPP.
Right.
Bye, Dad.
See you, buddy. Oh, how thoughtful. Directions to what used to be my own home.
And another fun thing we did when I was 5 was play pin the tail on the donkey.
What's that?
Well, it's where you put on a blindfold and you try and pin a paper tail on a paper donkey.
And then it blows up or something?
No. Well, why would you want to blow up a donkey?
I don't know. Why'd you want to pin a tail on one?
Look, Nick, why don't you run outside and play for a while? And today, try to remember to stay out of that puddle.
Oh, Tom, I haven't seen you in a few days. Nick's mommy tells me the party has been moved to your house. I'm telling you right now, I don't wear stupid hats.
You're coming?
Well, of course. My students are like family to me. Is there an open bar? Joke. Tom. You know, this being a dad is harder than most people realize. I think you might have the makings of a pretty good one.
Thanks. Have you seen Bobby and Carl?
Yes, they're outside, I believe, playing on the pirate ship. I think Carl is the captain today.
Avast there, matey. There be dangerous shores ahead.
When is it going to be my turn, steer?
These are pretty treacherous waters. Are you sure you're up to it, me hearty?
Yes, because it's not a real boat.
Do you like your new dress?
Yes.
Do the other kids like it?
Yes.
Did you tell them where they could buy it?
Yes.
That's my girl. Hey, guys, calling an emergency dad power meeting at the fire engine.
Ooh, I love the fire engine.
Hey, Lauren called us about to change your plans for the party. Way to go, buddy.
Yeah, good job. I got nothing.
What?
Yeah, it's been 3 days, and there are no Barneys in Chicago. There's no Barneys in Illinois. I found a lead on a Barney in Milwaukee. He won't be out of rehab for another 3 weeks.
What do you need a Barney for anyway?
I told Lauren I had the whole party planned.
Oh, you lied.
Well, I'm not a fan of Barney, but I would never use him in a lot.
Why don't you just call my party planner? I bet he could help you with this.
I can't afford a party planner.
Ah, you don't want that kind of party anyway.
What, you didn't like Sarah's birthday party?
The coronation? Oh, it was very nice.
What is that supposed to mean?
Nothing. I was just gonna say the kids have just as much fun at a Chuck E. Cheese party. Like we had for Molly, the kids love the pizza, there's party favors, and for the grown-ups, you get beer.
Yeah, not to mention, there's a guy dressed like a rat.
He is a mouse. Are you telling me Molly's party wasn't any fun?
No, it was delightful. In fact, I was just telling Dahlia the other day, we should go there sometime without the kids.
Come on, guys, I'm in big trouble here.
That's why you're gonna throw the best party you can. And let me pick up the entertainment, because I'm there for you 100%.
No, let me get the entertainment, because I am there for you 1,000%.
Well, I am there for you 1,000,000%.
There is no such illion.
As if you know.
Guys, you're acting like a couple of children.
What? Take a time out.
You're not the boss of us.
Okay.
It is not enough to say we will do something, is it, Melinda? We must do what we say. On the other hand, you're a lawyer, so this may not be possible for you.
Are you all right?
Wow, she's tough. She's Harvey Keitel tough. Oh, listen, your wife called to ask Henry to go to your son's birthday party.
Ex-wife.
Oh, right. Anyway, I just think it is so great that you've planned this party for your son. I mean, if the crumb that I was married to tried even a tenth as hard to be as good a dad as you, we'd still be married.
Well, speaking as a former crumb, I got to admit that lately I'm feeling a little overwhelmed. I don't know how you moms do it.
You see, if the crumb had admitted to even that, I would have found it very appealing.
Well, let me tell you, really, really overwhelmed. Drowning in overwhelmness.
It's been a while, huh?
Yeah.
See you at the party.
Hi, kid. I'm Mr. Sock. And I'm Mrs. Sock.
And this party socks. Where's Barney?
We want Barney. Oh. We want Barney.
All right, kids, all right. Obviously, it is time for my Sound of Music medley. Everybody out back. I have 12 minutes of material, then you're on your own.
Carl?
Huh?
I know he's your friend, but I gave up double overtime for this.
Dad, I'm not having any fun, and all my friends want to go home.
It'll get better, I promise. I have some entertainment coming. It's a special surprise.
What is it?
Well, like I said, it's a surprise, and you'll just have to wait like everyone else. Guys, I'm doing sock puppets here. Where's the entertainment?
Don't you worry, pal. Mr. Lizard should be here any minute.
Mr. Lizard?
One of the top five reptile guys in the Chicago area. He's an old high school friend. Even then, we called him Mr. Lizard.
Why?
Because he kept a lizard in his mouth.
So even in high school, you were in the cool group. Lizards are okay. But what kids really like are petting zoos. And this is my petting zoo guy now.
Hello?
I'm Maury. My assistants are setting up the animals in the back. Oh, we got you a beautiful selection. A rabbit, fox, raccoon, and three minks. Would have brought a seal, but I got an order.
What happens to these animals after the party?
Nothing the kids need ever know about. Excuse me.
What? I'm in the garment industry. I did the best I could.
Mr. Lizard! Hey! You look good!
Tom, there are some really unsavory characters back there setting up the weirdest petting zoo I ever saw. Hello?
Hi. Ah!
That still kills me. Why don't you go set up in the back, Liz?
These are the people you got for a five-year-old's birthday party?
Well, actually, this isn't just Tom's fault. I mean, we were all involved in this.
Oh, so this is the work of three brains.
Well, we like to think of it as dad power.
It's a special power, and oh, my children need me.
Me too.
Well, Tom, this isn't a competition.
You know, when that invitation came, it reminded me that Nick's home was a place away from me. I wanted to show him that this was his home, too, that I was there for him. That I might not have been there for him before, but that I am now. Guess I really showed him, huh?
Oh, we gotta get out here. Mr. Lizard was letting his python say hi to the other guy's bunny, and he just swallowed him whole.
Oh, my God.
Nikki,
there's something I need to tell you. Sometimes in nature...
It was so cool!
It was?
This is the best birthday party I ever had. Come on, Mom, you gotta see this.
Okay.
Tom, I'm really sorry. The bunny is completely gone.
But don't worry, Shirley got the whole thing on tape.
You know what the problem is with this whole dad power thing?
Huh?
We need to get better organized. I mean, great parenting like that snake eating the bunny isn't something you can just count on.
I know what you mean. That was like a gift from God.
Oh, yeah. Maury, Mr. Lizard, God's fingerprints were all over that one.